Hello, painting friends. My name is Michael, and as I have promised you, here I am back with the second part of my painting of Golden Autumn. Thanks for being back with me once again, and now let's finish this one. Today it's time to create here the shadows. I have decided to change the pathway into a carpet full of grass and fallen leaves. For that I have taken this time once again one of my favorite brushes, MA brush 15-7. This brush is also very quick. I'm going with these fan brushes always from left to right. Now changing to brush 15-8. This is also very nice fan brush. And this one has much more volume, gives a very nice round full effect. Looks like the grass is very full and rich, or the ground is coming up. Can also paint stones with that one. I use colors like the dark green for the shadow area here of the left tree. So imagine the sun is coming somewhere from the left side. Even that the sun is highlighted at the middle in this painting, it could be just a highlight of a very bright cloud there in the background. Once again, you can see me how I'm changing the painting. In the middle of it, I'm trying again new ideas. I had that feeling that this one should be completely in nature, without any pathway where somebody can suddenly appear. I think that the watcher of this painting will feel like this is a very abandoned place, a very nice place to be if you have found it. And you can be sure that nobody is coming here and could interrupt your peace and your special moment, just you and nature. I think these are thoughts that should be always considered, and they play a role in every painting. As I'm painting on one layer, here now I want to create a highlight from the sun hitting the grass on that place. And this is why I am selecting that area. When you don't paint on many layers, this little trick will help you too. Paint on the background area, and don't be too accurate here. Just go for it. I had paintings painted on around 170 layers, and I wanted to go back to my normal painting experience without thinking anything of layers and just painting. That's why I've also created the brushes and the magic canvas. Now let's paint the highlighted grasses here. And I'm using that same brush that I have used. It's a fan brush. When you make them very small, around 20 to 30 pixels, it will create very nice effects. And I found out this is very good to paint grass. Paint grass always quickly and with round strokes. It's very much fun to paint that grass. Now grab a little bit of the red tones and start to indicate here some fallen leaves. For example, here I will paint the shadowed grass, and for the highlighted areas, take the green and go for it. I like very much how these thin grasses came out. Now I'm mirroring it to test if it looks good, to see it from another perspective. I really like it so far. I I am very happy that I have changed that middle area. Now once again, take a nice red tone and bring it to that ground. And also some yellow orange tones. And now it's time to mix them a little bit. That area will fit to the tree area. I'm taking always care that the painting style and overall look will fit together, especially in a digital painting where you use different brushes. It is important to have not different styles at different places, but to have it somehow unique. So if you are using that palette knives here on the leaves of the trees, it is good to use it also at the ground. And this will look more harmonic, and this is very important, so be conscious about that when you are painting. I love to create little trees and tree trunks, like here. The forests are full of little trees, and the observer is mainly seeing just the big ones. But I feel like that younger trees, they are very important to have them also in a painting. They help that the painting is looking not maybe too stiff with just big trees. So don't forget their children. I'm using here the Dodge tool once again, set to highlight, to bring light to that areas here in between the trees. Now I've already signed that painting. I thought I was ready, but I wanted to make some last steps, and I feel like they are really important and they make a difference. This is often the case that I think I'm finished, but after a while I have a new idea, and this one really makes a change in the painting. For that I'm selecting now all the areas of the trees and the ground created with the palette knives. And I'm copying them, and now I'm pasting them to the impasto layer of the magic canvas. This will be just the second layer, and it is created just through copy and pasting. Here's some last corrections of the trees, that they look not too even. I want to bring that tree trunk a little bit to the right side. And here a little baby tree to the right side, and some highlights. I have to say, I am very happy with the outcome of this painting. In no way I was planning it to look like that. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for watching. I hope you could benefit a little bit by watching this painting. Next will be the MA colors, so stay connected to this channel by subscribing. See you next time. Bye bye.